Welcome back. Whether it's water bottles or grocery bags, plastics can have a huge impact on the environment. So today, Chemical Kim is here to share an experiment that shows us the harm it can do, particularly with aquatic life and the challenge that scientists have in finding a new way. We've got to do away with some of this plastic that's everywhere.
Exactly. So what I want to present today is to get kids to think using science, is there an alternative way to making plastic? Mm-hmm. And so I'm actually going to show them how they can make plastic from a potato. Interesting about plastic is that when it goes into any environment, in terms of it breakdown, it does not biodegrade, Catherine. What it does is it photodegrades.
So it breaks apart.
It breaks apart, exactly. Feed the fish.
See those? So those break up and they go into those little pieces. A fish sees that and says, ooh, supper.
Exactly.
They eat that and we're losing hundreds and thousands
millions
of fish.
Millions of fish and mammals.
Yeah.
And this is a huge, huge issue in our environment. So can kids come up with a solution? And this is actually one of the solutions, and kids can actually make this plastic at home.
The white kind. The
exactly.
green kind is the plastic kind.
Right, the from petroleum, from crude oil. Okay, and this is actually from starch, which is a food product, and I could actually eat one.
Oh my gosh, Kim. Kim!
I'm a fish.
So, put them in.
Mm-hmm.
You need to take a minute and chew those up.
They are so good, Catherine. And I'm not going to, you know, again, I will share it with my fish friends as this floats into the ocean, right?
Yes.
And it will dissolve
you
very
can feel
safely,
it the minute
very,
it contacts
very safely.
The water.
Yeah, that's actually a starch acetate, and that's what we're going to make. So, from that, let's go through the ingredients of how kids can make plastic at home. It's very, very simple.
Okay.
And it's interesting science.
I feel like I might have to give you a whack in the back.
The ingredients for making a potato plastic. Very simply, you would grate your potato and eventually pull out the starch, which is easy to do. You just grate the potato and squeeze the juice out of that potato, and you have starch.
Okay.
And the proportion, so I upped them up a little bit, is a tablespoon of potato starch. So you're going to
put that
into the beaker.
Okay.
And then 4 tablespoons of water, and you'll mix that in there too.
Okay.
I'll let you mix that. And then a teaspoon, and again, I up these proportions, but a teaspoon of vinegar, and that's where the acetate comes from.
Okay.
And that actually breaks down a molecule in starch that doesn't let starch plasticize.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so that's an important ingredient. And then glycerin, which is sort of a binding agent for the plastic.
Wow, it's thick. I never knew glycerin was like that. Okay.
Yeah, it also helps with bubbles. So it's a really good ingredient for bubbles. Okay, so you would mix that until you get that complete mix, and it is a cloudy material.
Mm-hmm.
And then you're going to, with adult supervision,
you're
going to heat this up on a stove. Okay.
Set that right on it?
Set that right on it. And as it's heating, you want to mix it, okay? And we're going to keep mixing and mixing, and it usually takes about 5 to 10 minutes. And you don't want to, you know, exactly. And you'll get it to this consistency right here. And does that not look like plastic?
Yes, it does.
And then
it's
just exactly. And I'll give you that. Be careful; the bottom is slightly warm.
Okay.
And then you'll pour that out onto a surface and allow about a 72-hour drying.
Okay.
This is a 24-hour drying right here
of
some plastic that I've made.
It's obviously not going to build a structure, but it's a start, and that's what Kim wants you to do. If you want activities from Chemical Kim, you may find them all on our website, WZZM13.com. Undertake 5 links. Start thinking about science and the application in our world. See you tomorrow or Monday.